गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक डिटरमिनेंट्स ऑफ 12th स्टैंडर्ड स्टूडेंट्स. हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द डिटरमिनेंट्स. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग दैट द डिटरमिनेंट्स. सो इफ वी आर सॉल्विंग द मैट्रिक्स देन वी फाइंड दैट द If there are the two equations are given, suppose that a1x plus b1y is equal to c1, another equation is a2x plus b2y is equal to c2. Then for the solution of that matrix we are going, take the coefficient of x and y, a1, a2, b1, b2, another variable x and y and constant c1 and c2. So after multiplying we can find the solution of that given matrix using the equation. After that we are solving for the matrix. In the case of the matrix, first how we can denote the matrix. The matrix is determinants is written in the form of as like this mod. So this is called the determinants, and determinants there are the written in the form of row and columns. The elements are written in the form of the row and columns. There are the row that the line. Here you can see this line A1, A12, A13. This is called as the row. This is called as the R1. It means first row. This is the second row, R2, and this is the third row, means R3. And here that this is the first column, this is called as the C1, this is the second column, this is called as the C2, and this is the third column, this is called as the C3. So in the determinants, that is a row and columns. Row are called R1, R2, and R3. This is the elements in all three rows, and column C1, C2, C3. Here is also the elements are in the column. Here is the three column and three roots. So you can say this is the square determinants in the form of 3 by 3. That the order is a 3 by 3. Because it is written A is equal to Aij. Aij, here I is a row and j is a column. Number of the row, it is a denoted by I, and number of the column, it is a denoted by j. Okay. Here, how we can expand these determinants? For the expansion of the determinants and solution of that determinants, what sign we can put up in the this condition? This is the formula written in the form of minus 1 to the power I plus j. I plus j, here you see, the for the first element, A11. A11, it means minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. It means minus 1 to the power 2, so it is equal to positive. So this value is here written as the positive. Here I write down that first element, it is a positive. In the second condition, minus 1 to the power 1 plus 2, it is a 3. 1 plus 2, it is a 3. So minus 1 to the power 3, it is equal to negative. So it is a minus. Then after that, A13, I is equal to 1 and j is equal to 3, 1 plus 3, it is equal to 4, minus 1 to the power 4, it means it is equal to plus 1. Next, a21 for the second row, a21, 2 plus 1, this is the 3, so it is a negative. Next, a22, 2 plus 2, it is a 4, it is a positive. a23, 2, 3, 5, it means negative. A31, it means 4, it is a positive. A32, it means 5, so it is a negative. A33, 3 plus 3, it is a 6, so it is a positive. So here you can say for the expansion, these signs are denoted in the minus 1 to the power I plus j. Okay. So suppose that we just wanted to expand the matrix. Suppose that one matrix is given, here is a A and B, C and D. It is a matrix of order 2 by 2 because here you see first row is a R1 and second row is a R2 and first column is a C1 and second column is a C2. If we just want to find the solution of that matrix, then we write down that mod of this matrix, suppose that A, it is equal to here multiply first element to the here last element, A multiply with the D through the positive sign and C multiply with the B through the negative sign. So this is equal to A into D minus C into B. Okay, so we find the solution of that type of the matrix. Suppose that here 3 by 3 matrix is given. 3 by 3 it means 3 column and 3 rows. So how we can expand? Suppose that A11, this is equal to A11, it is a positive. If we take the first element, then we remove first row and first column and take rest element. Rest element, it is equal to here that A22 and A23, next A32 and A33. This is the positive because A11, it is a positive. Then A12, here you multiply, then A12 second elements, here is a negative sign. So here you put up minus, then matrix. You remove this row and this column. So this is the, here remove, then this is equal to A23. And then A33, after that A21 and A31. For the third condition, third element A13, it is a positive because I to the power 1 and J to the power 3. So 13, therefore this is equal to, here you see, you remove this row and this column. So the element A21 and A22 and A31 and A32. So do the expansion of these forms and you solve the matrix because this is the for the row. Similarly, you can solve for the column. Suppose that you take the first column, then you remove the first row and first column. Same elements. Second column, then you remove this row and this column and you take another element for the expansion. So you according to this, you find the solution by the row and columns. Okay, I think all of you understand about the matrix, how you can solve. You solve on the basis of the row and column, expansion of either row, either column. If you just wanted to take into the column, then you can say that you take the column, otherwise you can take in the row. Here some examples of the exercise are given related to the solution of the matrix, sorry, determinants. So all of you see, here is the in your textbook, the exercise number 4.1 is given some questions related to the solution of these determinants. So first questions, evaluate. First question is that here matrix is given 2, 4 and minus 5, then 1. Evaluate that determinants. For the evaluation of that determinants, I say that A is the determinants of the elements 2 and 4 of the first row and second row minus 5 and 1. So after that the solution, it means mod A. Mod A is equal to, you multiply this element, so 2 multiply 1 and this element multiply with the negative sign, so minus minus 5 and into 4. So 2 ones are 2, minus and minus it is converted into the plus, and 5 fours are 20, so this is equal to 22. So the value of that determinants, it is equal to 22. Okay, you can find out as like this. For the second question, here also you see second question, second of first question, that is given cos theta and minus sin theta, and second sin theta and cos theta. The elements are given. Here also you find the solution of that matrix. So I think I take the this determinants A is equal to cos theta minus sin theta and sin theta and cos theta. So you follow the rules of expansion. Here you apply first element, multiply the last elements. So here cos theta into cos theta, and for the negative sign, so minus, here is a sin theta and into minus sin theta. So you see that cos theta into cos theta, it means cos square theta minus and minus, it is equal to plus sin theta and sin theta, this is equal to sin square theta. Here you see sin square theta and plus cos square theta. This is the formula of the trigonometry. In the trigonometry, sin square theta and plus cos square theta, this is equal to 1. So solution of that determinants, it is equal to plus 1. So you apply this method and you find the solution of the matrix, this determinants, this is the determinants of order 2 by 2. After that, we are going to solve the determinants of order 3 by 3. 3 by 3, either you can say it is a square matrix, because in the case of the square matrix, the element of row and column both are the same. So, question number 3. Here is a determinants are given 3, minus 1 and minus 2, first row, second row 0, 0 and minus 1, in the third row 3, minus 5 and 0. These are the elements of the determinants. So I say A is equal to that determinants. Then how we can solve? So you apply the formula for the expansion. If you apply the formula for the expansion, so there is equal to, here is equal to 3. So I write down 3. If I take the first element of the row, then I remove this row and this column. And here it is a A11. This is the A12 and this is the A13. 11, it means minus 1 to the power 1 plus 1. It is equal to 2. So it is a positive. I take the elements. The elements are, I remove this row and this column. So the remaining element 0, minus 1, minus 5 and 0. Next, after that, we take the next element. This is the minus 1. Minus 1, here is a formula that A to the power I plus j, so it is equal to minus, because negative sign, because 1 plus 2 it is a 3, so minus, minus 1 and the elements. If I take these elements A12, so I remove this row and this column. So the elements are here, that is a 0 and 3, this element is 0 and 3, and this element is a minus 1 and 0. After that, we take the another element here, A13, it means minus 1 to the power 1 plus 3, it is equal to 4, so it is a positive. So plus and bracket minus 2 and the elements. Here I remove this row and this column. If I remove this row and this column, so this is equal to 0, 0 and 3 and minus 5. Then you see this is equal to 3 and bracket. 0 multiply by 0, it is equal to 0. This multiply with the negative sign. So minus 5, 1 ja 5, minus and minus, it is a plus. Minus and minus, it is a plus 1. 0, 0 ja 0. And 3, 1 ja 3. So minus and minus, it is a plus 3. Minus and plus, it is a minus 2. And 0, 5 is 0 and 3 zeros are 0, so it is equal to 0. Here you see 3 5s are 15, so minus 15 plus 1 3s are 3 plus 3, so it is equal to minus 15 plus 3, so therefore this is equal to minus 12. So the solution of that determinants, it is equal to minus 12. And you can solve, apply this method of the order of the determinants 3 by 3. Next, how you can evaluate the values of x if both matrix determinants are given? If the two determinants are given in the form of the equation, then how you can solve the values of given any variable? Here the question is given. So question number 7, that 2, 4 and 5, 1. This is the determinants. Another determinants is 2x, 4 and 6 and x. So first we expand the determinants. 2 ones are 2, 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4 is equal to 2x into x, it means 2x into x and minus 6 into 4. So 2 ones are 2 and minus 5 fours are 20. It is equal to 2x square and minus 6 fours are 24. Then 2 minus 20, it is a minus 18 is equal to 2x square minus 24. Then here minus 18 and plus 24, it is equal to 2x square. I transfer 24 in another side, so it is converted into the positive. 24 minus 18, it is equal to 6. 6, it is equal to 2x square. Either 2x square, it is equal to 6, yeah, or x square is equal to 6 upon 2, this is equal to 3. So x square, it is equal to 3. After taken square root, x is equal to plus minus under root 3. So the solution of x, it is equal to plus minus under root 3, it means it has two value. One value is a plus under root 3, another value is a minus under root 3. Similarly, one other example is given in the questions. If the two determinants are equal, then evaluate the value of x. Here, one determinant is given x 2 and 18 x. The elements of determinants is equal to 6, 2, 18 and 6. Both determinants are equal, then how you can find the solution of that equations, that determinants? So apply the method similarly in the previous questions. So x into x, it is a x square minus 18 to the, this is the 36, it is equal to 6, 6 the 36 minus 18 to the 18 to the, it is a 36. So you see here x square minus 36, 36, 36, this is equal to 0. So x square, it is equal to 36, x is equal to plus minus 6. So here you see that x is equal to plus minus 6. So you apply this method, you find the value of x. So I think all of you understand how we can solve the determinants of the order 2 by 2 and order 3 by 3 and 2 by 3 and what is a row and what is a column and how we can solve the given questions related to the exercise. So I think all of you understand. Okay, goodbye.